Hi guys, it's lycheepunnet here for take two of our review of the Love Live School Idol movie
I'm a
Extra
shitter.
Booster. El Prez screwed something up.
What? It was just OBS. It didn't read my microphone.
Yeah, sure, that's what it
Blame it on
was.
OBS, huh?
I always blame it on
Yeah.
OBS. So we've got El Prez,
When
who
the
is the
tech
one
stops working,
recording.
you know what I'll be blaming.
Yeah, so we have translations this time, and we should introduce everybody. So I'm lycheepunnet, this is El Prez,
Sup?
and this is Thomas, who actually plays Love Live.
We judge
Kind
him.
of.
But okay, hello.
Yeah, well, I play Love Live too, but not Love Live, Love Live.
No, you just troll with
So
Love Live cards.
I guess that's the case. Anyway, so this booster is the latest in a long line of cards for this particular series. So there's quite a lot to take in. We've done our best to cover what we can, but if we miss anything, please let us know. And we may or may not address it in the comments. So I guess without further ado, I guess we should talk about the rating system. It's been a while. So the rating system goes from good to bad. Good cards are cards you start in the deck. They're cards that actively make you want to play this build or this deck. And they are cards you should be on the lookout for when you crack your boosters or make your singles orders. Then we have the next rundown is playable. These cards will fill out some of your deck. There will be role players because this is Weiss. It's a game where you move from stage to stage. You need role players. So you need level ones, you need level threes. So even if the card is not pants on head retardedly good, you may need to play it because it fills a specific role. Now, in the case of Love Live, this may not be the case because there are so many cards you can choose from, but it is the case in a lot of boosters, so we'll just keep it at that. A subset of this particular rating is niche. So niche cards are cards which go only in one or two specific builds and doesn't really pull its weight outside those builds. So these can include cards specifically for, relevantly, waifu decks, or for cards built around, or for decks built around certain character pairs. You'll see that a bunch in this particular set because Love Live has moved towards becoming a set that rewards you for playing just one character. And lastly, we have the bad rating, which is just these cards, they're really bad, as as the rating may tip you off on. But the definition of bad is either it is completely outclassed by something else, or it is actively bad, as in its effects will move you towards losing the game as opposed to winning it. So now that we've gone past that, we can move on to actually reviewing the cards. We have the shiny new translation bit up the top,
So
courtesy
shiny,
of
so new.
yeah, it's courtesy of El Prez deciding to finally get off his ass and fix it.
I didn't fix
And
it. I'm just hoping it doesn't break.
okay, last time we tried it, it broke. So hopefully it works this time, and hopefully it'll be there for the foreseeable future. So the first card is Angelic Angel, Nozomi Tojo. It is what we call an Azusa clone. It's a 2K card that comes down and allows you to discard a card from hand. And if you do, look at up to four cards from the top of your library and add one green character to your hand and discard the rest. So, I was kind of psyched. First set review in a while, but then we start on this card archetype, which I'm obligated by this point to absolutely hate, and there's just not much I can do about it. It's just such a good card, it's unfair, and yeah, like I don't even have to say anything. He's put the ratings up. This
Yeah.
card, yeah, like it gives you a free, a stockless discard outlet. It replaces that card you discard with a presumably better card. And this one in particular doesn't really warp your deck building in a way which affects the overall game plan.
Yeah. I feel like we've touched this so much. The only reason why this card doesn't get a meta rating ever anymore is 'cause like so many sets get one now, and this isn't even like the best version of this card.
And Love Life. That's right. I forgot to talk about the meta rating, which is the designation we give to cards that are so good they make you want to buy the booster.
God
But
damn it,
that's,
to lover.
yeah, basically, that's all we need to say about it. This card is actually good enough to pull you towards going more green than what you used to go in Love Live. Although I feel like a lot of meta Love Live decks have slowly moved towards green.
This
I'm
does give
not.
you a greater incentive to slide towards it, though.
I feel like the blue one is still better. There are still more blue cards at every level that you want to grab than
Yeah.
green, you
And since there is a exact copy of this card, but with Marquee on it instead, that gets blue cards. This card is good, but I don't know whether it'll be the one seeing play outside of like a specific third. Is their third years, right? The final year?
Yeah.
A third year's deck or a deck running very heavy on green to abuse like the, I guess the Ellie combo or the Nico Stock Charger or any number of reasonably good cards.
Yeah.
I mean, there's lots of good green cards in Love Life.
Yep.
I don't know, what can I say? The card is just, it's bonkers, and I wish I had it in my sets.
I'm already moving on.
Yeah, that's fair.
There's so many things I have to update now.
Yeah, making him work for it.
I need a plug-in or something.
Yeah, got to get these shortcuts going. So the next card is another Angelic Angel. This one's Eli Ayase. So it's a 217k. It's not a great start. For each of your other music characters, this gains 500 power. It's a 219k, I suppose. I don't remember the last time 219Ks were super good, but we'll roll with that. And then it has, when this attacks, if Angelic Angel is in the climax zone, you may choose a card in your clock and add it to your hand. I mean, yeah, and yes, and add it to your hand. If so, put the top card of your library in your clock. So Angelic Angel is the stock soul. The green stock soul, obviously. What else is there to say about this card? I don't think it's bondable. Oh wait, no, it is exactly bondable. It is a printed card. Never mind me. Yeah, I misread this as the one below. So this card is notable because it's bondable by an Irisa card, which is her little sister, if I recall correctly.
Does that card have a music trait?
It does now, I believe. It used to not have music trait, but now she's in a band or something.
It does have music trait, yes.
Yeah, so it's a
Oh,
0/0.
it also it's apples except a 2/1.
Yeah, so it's the same as the Araragi Senjogahara combo. So
That does not make this card better, honestly.
no, I don't think it
Yeah.
does.
No.
No, it's
No.
not that good.
I put meh.
I think it's playable if you really like if you really want an Ellie that meh is not a thing.
Meh.
I say niche just for the other day.
I think niche is correct actually, because it is just for the Ellie
God damn
deck.
it. Stop making me work for this.
That's my entire purpose now. So this card is niche because I don't see it featuring in any in a meta Love Live deck. Because there are already decent level twos that you can play, and there are also advanced summon level threes, which are pretty good. There's a Hanyo later in this later in this booster that's pretty good. There's the old Maki, which is pretty good. A whole bunch of cards which are pretty good that take the place of this card and do more. So while
Basically.
it's nice that it's bondable, but that's kind of all. Like it doesn't really do anything else. It's kind of big, but at the same time, it's only a one soul beater, and you have to pay a lot of stock to make that one soul beater quite big.
Yep. All right.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, while I start working.
Yeah, making him work for it. So we'll just move on to the next card. That card is We Are a Single Light, Nico Yazawa. It's the third double R for green. If you hadn't realized, those two cards are double Rs. So right now, the dodgy double R is the Ellie, whereas the Nozomi is a pretty decent one. But I think this Nico takes both of them. Ooh. This is a pretty good card, yeah. So
Three card.
yeah, so this Nico is a 3/2 10k. It's got coming it comes into play and you can heal one, so put the top card of your clock in the waiting room. And when this attacks,
Yes.
if We Are a Single Light is in the climax zone, so We Are a Single Light is the 9-character super feature climax, which is it's a bar, it's a gate, and it's a pants trigger, is that correct?
Yes, that
Yeah,
is correct.
so it's like a whole bunch of different climax combos, which is really strong, because the climax combos are quite strong.
Oh, god damn it, the translation's broke.
Oh, they broke.
Oh wait, maybe not. One sec.
Oh.
Let me make sure. And we're good.
Get good.
It's all
So
good.
this Nico, its climax combo with We Are a Simple Light is: when this attacks, you may pay one. If you do, this card gains 2,000 power and the ability to clock kick the reversed battle opponent. So clock kicks have been on the downswing recently because every set is getting a sac counter.
Yeah.
But at the same time, this is
Yeah.
still a very efficient clock kick.
It is a pay one clock kick. It's kind of tragic that it's a pay one clock kick attached to a climax combo.
It's a preemptive clock kick, and the
Yeah.
reason it's attached to a climax combo, I think, is they value heals above draw two, drop one. But this one also gets 2K power
I
on
think it's
top
I
of
think
that.
the reason why they're charging you is for the 2K power.
You think?
I
Yeah,
think
I guess
so.
that's a
You
fair enough.
usually the
Yeah.
climax combos that are just give clock kick.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
I believe you're getting charged for the power. And honestly, the clock kick is good. It's very, very solid card. I don't think I want to be running this over the other Nico, the older one, just
The
because
minus one
the
soul.
minus one soul is really good defensively, but also it can still clock it on opponent's turn, which does to an extent let you play around whatchamacallit,
Yummy.
Sack
I
count,
think
sac
yeah.
counters primarily.
Oh, that's fair, yeah.
The big
That's
thing
fair.
is because of the minus one soul, you can't even like side effectively with a plus two soul on a level three. I mean, the only character that can get through that is Toma.
Yeah, no, that's fair.
So like it, as a defensive character, it punishes your opponent super heavily the way the abilities are all stacked up, and I don't think this is more effective than that.
I agree with you, but at the same time, I don't think the old Nico is great defensively because it is just a 10K.
The
This
biggest,
card is
yeah.
also just a 10K, sure, but it gets value as soon as you play it,
The biggest
so.
downside I think for the old Nico, as far as an argument is concerned, is that the minus one soul in circumstances where they only need to get one damage in will definitely kill you a lot.
Yeah, that is an issue that a lot of people who dislike minus one soul will cite, and I completely agree. Yeah, but the real thing you have to take into account with this card is it's Nico, so it's basically unplayable to begin with.
Well, we're
Savage.
talking about this in comparison with the other Nico, so like.
Savage. That said, I'm gonna give the card a playable rating. I don't think it's better per se than the older Nico, but it's definitely serviceable if you have the climax slots to spare.
I think it's good.
I think it's good as well. Yeah,
I
you can
just really
just.
dislike that
It's
you
a
have to pay on
pretty. No.
attack.
See, you don't need the climax slots to spare because you can just put
Yeah.
the Maki combo and.
Oh,
It's a
sure.
super efficient climax, as far as deck building goes.
I just dislike paying for clock kicks on like preemptively because it just makes it so easy to play around.
I mean, clock kicks were already kind of easy to play around, though.
Yeah, but like when you pay it before you attack, it's like screaming, "I am so gonna try to clock kick you right here." I don't know.
Yeah, that's fair.
I mean, like
Yeah,
the
that's
best
fair.
clock kicker
Yeah.
I think is probably like the Sasami, I guess. I don't know. It's like super low budget and. Or not low budget, but I mean like low like deck impact wise. So like that's always like the gold standard. But like even I think I still like Komachi, for instance, from Terraformers better than this.
Yeah, I think I agree.
But I don't know. We are single. It's a gold bar, right?
It's a
No,
gold
it's a
bar, it's
gold
a gate,
bar,
and it's
pants,
pants.
oh, gold
and
bar, gate,
yeah.
and pants. Oh,
It's
okay.
all
So it's
three.
one of those things. So it's gonna
And
combo
all
with a
of
couple
the
other level threes. Yeah, yeah,
your all the cards that is climax, like climax combo, the climax is climax combo with each other. So
Okay.
you can run a level one advantage engine
I mean,
plus this.
for the sake of consistency, I think I'd still pick the gold bar over the other two climax triggers at the moment, but that ultimately comes down to like what colors you are
I would
running.
probably
Oh.
pick pants because the Maki combos would be what I'd focus on.
Okay, sure.
Wait, no, they all combo with the same. They all combo with each other.
Yeah, that's what I mean, but
We're
in
talking about the
terms of
trigger.
actual climax selection.
The trigger
No, but
matters.
like, the Nico will combo with the pants.
That's
No.
what I'm saying. I would choose the pants.
God damn. We're
I'm
discussing
saying
which trigger
that.
we would use for this combo.
Oh.
I would go with
Well.
pants probably because
There's a very good reason to choose Gold Bar. That's coming up soon.
I clearly haven't read this set well enough.
Alrighty. Well,
The next card
the card
is
is
our first
playable.
rare. So the first card is the first
Oh,
rare
here it
card
is.
is Angel. Oh, that's why. Angelic Angel, Nico Yazawa. So it's 005 500 power assist, so it gives 500 in front. And when your green climax is placed in the climax zone, you can choose a character, and that character gains 1 5 power for the turn.
It's
So
a Rider clone from Fate Zero.
it is a clone of that dude
Yeah.
from Charlotte.
What, Rider had it first. God damn it, people.
Yeah,
It's
so
the Rider
Bushiro
that's doing
decided.
the cooking wearing
I
the
don't
t-shirt.
see you calling them Akane clones.
Bushiro just like cycles effects a lot, so we'll go with that. So this Nico is a it's a good reason to run green blue because the Maki combo that I've been talking about so much is kind of really pathetically weak. So you need a card like this to pump it up. Did
Yeah.
I drop? Did the call drop? No, it didn't. It's just you guys being
No,
silent.
no.
No, I'm being silent.
Yeah,
This
sure.
card is. I can't say it's good, but it's definitely like something that you'd want to be running in your deck. Per se.
I think it's fine.
I'm saying it's not good rating. It's a very, very solid card.
I think it might be what pushes the Maki combo to an actual playable level. Because as it stands, I don't think the Maki combo is very playable at all.
Ultimately, when we start talking about like putting multiple cards together to make a combo, it already lowers its value for me
You say
in
that,
general.
but 1/1 Yami?
Yeah, that card is heinous.
Yeah, so I rest my case.
That card is heinous for a lot of reasons.
This one does effectively the same thing.
True. It also does one less stock.
It also doesn't cost stock, correct?
Nah. Like for me it's like the Yami, or sorry, the Mikan is playable without the Yami. It's just with the Yami, you get over things that you previously could not
The
have.
Maki is playable without the Nico as well.
Is I
It's
believe
just.
it's the same kind of profile, right?
Yeah, it's a similar profile,
No,
just.
no, no. Well, it's a different costless advantage, but it's
It's
yeah.
like the Minami from Cinderella Girls.
Oh, okay.
It's similar, but yeah.
It's much worse.
Sure. That said, this card still only gets a playable rating from me.
I guess you just have to downgrade it because it's Nico.
Here, you can, I'm gonna put you giving it the bad rating then.
Wow.
No,
Just
this.
give it the Nico rating.
Yeah. Nico,
Nico
Nico,
D.
knee.
No, but in
Nice.
speaking frankly, if this card was like an Ellie or a Nozomi and I can rate it without being biased, then I would actually call this a good card.
I think it's a good card too.
I think that it drives the engine of the presumably playable deck.
This card definitely
Yeah.
encourages running more green climaxes when you can get away with it. Just cause.
And you can,
Am I
I
really
know,
gonna have
because you have
Nico Nico
options.
D
Run a
slaps next
gold
to my
bar
name?
that combos with everything.
Yeah.
Alrighty. I guess we can move on.
All right. So this next card is question mark heartbeat Eli Ayase. I don't understand these naming conventions for the songs. So it's a 1/0 2K. So it means it's a support. It's a assist in front to gain 1 level and 500 power. And you can tap it to give a music character 1K power for the turn.
So on one hand, level 1 bombs are becoming more and more prominent. On the other hand, this card still feels worse than the previous card.
I think so too, because the previous card does work at level 0 as well, and doesn't need you to have green leveled, which. Oh, I guess that if you want to use the Maki combo of the bar, you need green leveled anyway.
You need both, which is.
Yeah. I think this card is fine. But I also don't
It's
think it's as good as the Nico.
very playable.
Yeah, like
This card
it's
feels
just
worse than the Nico.
It's hard to say it's that bad,
yeah, like
because.
its effects are good in a vacuum. They just I don't know.
The
It's
other potential problem is like the investment you have to make into resting characters in Love Live, especially because you have the Brainstorms as
yeah.
well as like some other cards that
The
require
Nico
resting
and Umi
characters.
Brainstorms are both really solid, and having to rest
Yeah.
them is a big problem. There's also the Maki that we keep talking about, which really would prefer. Like, this is extremely redundant with that Maki, and we'll see why later. This
Alrighty.
card is this card is playable. That's all it really is.
Yep.
Is that Rin?
It is me.
Oh, yeah.
Sorry for the intrusion.
Yeah, we have another guy who actually plays Love Live. His name's Rin. Yes. He was on the last cast. We couldn't get everyone together, but we did manage to get Rin. He came back from work. He plays a bunch of decks. Yeah, we've gotten up to the Heartbeats Nozomi Tojo, which is 1045. It comes to play, gets 1/5 to become a 6K, and climax ? Heartbeat is placed to the climax zone. You choose one of your opponents at the front row, and that character gets a -2K.
This feels really, really bad.
This
card's really, really bad. Have you looked at the climax yet?
It's the climax,
it's a 2K1.
Oh dear god, it couldn't even be a 2-soul?
Yeah, it's a 2K1 soul.
At level 1! Oh my goodness.
It couldn't even be a 2-soul?
Yeah, it's effectively like a 4K buff, but...
It is a 2K1, yes.
Okay, yeah. So you got a 4K buff, which means functionally this card is 10K in one slot. Cool.
Yes. Amazing. For no stock.
And it loses that power the next turn.
And then 4/5. And then you attack their 9K body, and then they 2K counter you, and you lose anyways.
Not everyone plays Rhino or Terraformers, man.
Please.
Barely anyone actually plays walls, let's be honest.
Yeah, there's always that one guy who plays walls, but...
Okay, like that one guilty crown player at your locals. Okay, I feel you.
Except I don't even play walls anymore, I play index.
Or that Honoka player.
Yeah.
I don't even play walls anymore.
I've never been a big believer in walls.
Honoka dog deck still plays walls.
Yeah, I just guess it's a nice idea, nice time to address why I don't like walls. And it's just what we've been talking about. There's always someone bigger. It's just they're getting bigger counters on defense now, and they've got better supports at level 1. It's just really hard to really say, I'm going to wall up, and there's nothing you can do to stop me.
It's the most awkward thing when wall decks fight each other.
Yeah, because ironically, you don't ever want to front, because counters will always swing the game.
Yeah.
That's just how strong counters are right now. So I don't think this card is very good. I don't think it's even playable in a waifu deck, to be quite honest.
This card is pretty bad.
To be fair, Nozomi doesn't really have much outside level 1.
I wouldn't know.
What? She has perfectly serviceable, like, first power cards.
Is anyone giving it a not bad rating, or should I just put the waifu rating up?
I would personally say waifu. I think this card is good at getting rid of Hibiki. But...
I'm giving Rin. Rin put it down for waifu rating.
I'll be the climax combo to beat the Hibiki.
Doesn't Love Live have level 0 poppers?
Probably, but this one stops.
Squag Festival Umi.
Wouldn't you want to do that at level 0?
Oh,
there's also that.
I don't know. Can't say
some people. Part. Some people just can't play Hibiki to level 1 for some reason.
You're trying to salvage this card, but it isn't working, man.
No, I'm not trying to salvage this card. I'm like a whole
about.
Yeah, I'm trying to salvage the card because I'm like,
he's in.
I don't know, man. The card itself looks really stupid too. Or
that sunglasses. Non-foil. Yeah,
I'm right. Sure the foil looks fine.
You know what? I'm moving on. This card is just not good.
Sure. So we've gotten to Arisa, which is the bond to the 2-1 Ellie we talked about earlier. Again, this is a niche card because it only goes in the Ellie deck. And at that point, you're running not Ellie in an Ellie deck. So you have to wonder, what are you doing with your life?
You're playing shitty waifus. I don't know.
Yeah, we're probably saying yes as well.
Let's see how much hate I get for everything I say. If there's one thing I universally don't understand, it's anime idols. And the outrageous popularity they have.
I agree.
Okay, I'm gonna move on.
This is getting a little too far.
Oh, I think I, like, skipped some text. One sec. Anyways, feel free to talk about this.
This next one is an Ellie, so it's a 0/0... Wait. Oh, okay.
It's a 0/0 on play. If your opponent has 3 or more climaxes in your waiting room, rest this card.
Hey, this is actually like a really good beater.
Yeah, it's a nice screen level 0.
I would never ever play this card because if I ever have to feel this is a beater late game and it taps.
It feels bad, man.
It doesn't feel bad. It feels good losing.
To be fair, I feel pretty bad when I play my Toma and Index and I mill a Climax.
You still get a mill, and then you get
a Scry. Yeah, you get a mill and a Scry.
That card is great.
The Scry is fantastic. Anyways, that said, this is still like
a
niche beater. I'm sure there are better beaters at level 0.
I'm making a stand.
This is a niche.
I'm making a stand. This is bad. It actually goes towards
music. Actually, yeah, it's pretty. Yeah.
It actively.
Sadly, this isn't even the worst.
Like, at least Toma and Index, like, if you need it to stand, you get to Scry first and then try not to mill or Climax. You inevitably will, but.
You know, the saddest part is I always, like, when I need it to stand, I will Scry. It'll be a character. I'll leave it on top. Second card's a Climax, and I get sad. Yeah. Every time.
Correct. And this is why the level 3 Haru is complete garbage.
Now we're going off.
Man, it is if you're not good off topic. Haru is good, okay.
Look, man, I proxied the PR Onodera, and I got it, and I felt really good about myself, and then I realized that I still just had one clock kick and a 3-2 that did nothing.
I'm moving on.
Look, that card is bad, alright? That's my final judgment.
Look how efficiently I'm switching through these card texts now that I figure out how to do this like not a shitter.
I believe in you, Shinjito.
It needs to test your procedures before you actually do them.
No, this was done on the fly.
Next card.
Oh no, we didn't even know that.
So this card is Sunny Day Song Arisa Ayase. This card is a 1k counter, and it's a 1-0, so you know something's up. This is under par, but contrary to what I'm sure you're all expecting, this is not not anymore, because now we have translations. when you use this card's backup, you don't get an extra 1k for having a music character. Instead, you may pay 2, and if you do, search your library for a music character, reveal it, and add it to your hand. Then you shuffle.
Alright,
this
so...
is a Bosser account.
I like this card.
This card is actually kind of neat.
I like this card.
It's helpful.
I don't think it's good.
In certain builds where you just don't... Especially where... In a good amount of light builds where you just really don't pay stock out all too much, especially if you're playing more like the blue-centric deck, it's really helpful.
Like, it's a good stock out if you need to pay 1 or 2 stock. And it also thins your deck, which is really important in Weiss, because that's one less card you can take as damage. It's the same reason the board encounter that everyone goes nuts about is good, because you're removing one card from the deck that could be damaged. I mean, this is obviously weaker than the board encounter because you're paying a whole bunch. You're not getting an actual counter out of the deal. Like, 1K is not really a big deal, in my opinion.
Especially at level 1, where the power levels are so swingy.
Exactly. And you're not actually scrying something to the bottom. Like, you're not confirming that card is not damaged. You're just... rolling the dice again. But I still think this card adds to your hand, lets you get a card that you might need. It's a stock out. Yeah. I'm going to call this card playable because I don't think it screams amazing. Oh, you already wrote playable. Yeah, good for you.
I think it's just playable.
I need to type it in and then hit save or else it doesn't update.
That's fair. Yeah, no, I think this card is... It's pretty nice. It's nice to see a card which isn't copy-pasted from a previous set.
You know what the last time I counter got that?
But this is copy-pasted from a previous
set. It is copy-pasted from a previous
Sengoku
set.
Sengoku Basara.
But you know the last time we had a card like that I remember on a counter? And it was the 2-1 recycle counter from Terraformers almost a year ago.
That card doesn't get you a card out of your deck.
No, it doesn't. Unless, so like, you're about to refresh.
That card also kind of sucks because it's just pay 2 for a counter to pump something, which is... I'm not on that.
You pay 2.
I know that Phantom Thieves has a similar counter, but they don't get power out of it.
You pay 2. It's just an event. You get the card back, and it's...
My point is that not literally every set in recent memory has this effect, unlike certain other effects that I'm sure any observant.
Well, now they're just gonna put this card in every future set. Thanks.
Well, that's fine, because this is an overbearing card which demands a double R rating and that you play it.
Moving on. Mm-hmm. It's Nico.
Nico Yazawa.
Holy Jesus, this card is garbage.
Dude, just combos with the idol attackers, man.
I'm just gonna go ahead and start filling in bad everywhere.
He's correct. Yeah. He's correct in saying it combos with idol otaku, and this is
weak. And also combos with other things.
Yeah, this is weak. This especially combos with idol otaku because it makes a 12-5, which cool. is neat, I guess.
Nah, man. Clearly 15k. You're gonna just jam two of these in your front row.
You can because if you like ram two characters and then they only have one row that they can attack. You can attack. That they can attack you on, and that row is into a clock kick, which is pretty significant, I think. Like, I'm sure someone out there will play this in their Nico waifu deck for whatever reason. You have a Nico waifu deck.
There's a guy at my locals who has a Nico waifu deck.
There's a guy at my locals with a Nico waifu deck.
There's a guy at my locals with a Nico waifu deck.
Damn.
Not
mine.
Nico waifu deck's anonymous.
Well, none of us actually have one, so no.
We're recovering from our encounters with such things.
Well,
I don't think
I can rate when I was at Will's Locals, but that was it.
I've been to Will's Locals, and I didn't see his. I didn't see this.
I believe he was playing Dodai that tournament.
I didn't see. Oh, I saw Dodai. I didn't play against this.
Yeah.
Thank God.
He's like.
Anyway, this card I think is
most like in that game.
Because it does have particularly strong synergy against with that 3-2 Nico, which is a pretty big. It's a pretty decent card.
This card is still garbage.
I'm not still going to.
I'm not updating the rating. I'm not going to pay one.
Maybe Nico players can tell me otherwise. But
change my rating, damn it! So. Change it to niche. Nico niche.
We walk into that one, guys.
God, I hate myself right now.
Moving on.
Can we edit that out?
No.
No. We can't edit that out.
No.
I let you keep it in.
No. It's there.
You have to pay for your sins.
Just like Bika, you're paying for your sins for life.
Sunny Day Song Nozomi Tojo. This is a 2/1/8/5, which gives it vanilla stats. It cannot side attack, and when this is placed from hand to stage, if you have four more other music characters, I was honestly expecting four more other Nozomis, then you may put the top card of your library in stock. So it's a 2/0 with a blind stock.
Can I just...
if it's the last card you can.
Does anyone think this card is good? Because I'm putting it bad for me.
I don't think it's bad. It seems
playable.
Like in a back.
Do I want to be playing 2/1 or 2/0 8500 power beaters?
I don't think it's a terrible prospect, given that a lot of decks
eat value.
Most decks will play like 10Ks that will have like their level 2 fields will be an advanced summon and then 2 level 1s left over.
Yeah.
This level 2 comfortably beats over the level 1s, and if the level 3 tries to kill this level 2, you can quite easily counter. So I think 2/1s are, right now, they're underrated, but still not amazing. So I can't give this card a bad rating.
I say it's playable.
I think it's playable as well, because it's definitely not niche and it's definitely not bad.
I hate all of you.
I will probably say waifu at best. I don't know about playable.
Cool. Rin's gonna give it the waifu rating.
Because you can definitely run something like the 2/1 Umi or the 2/2 Ellie, and those are really fat and can sometimes take down level 3s.
One of the big reasons why I like 2/2s though is because 2 soul.
Yeah. I agree.
I mean, that's like the predominant reason why.
You aren't paying
stock. True.
You
aren't paying
stock. What, you just gotta play the one from Attack on Titan that you don't pay for stock twice.
That one's an interesting card.
That card's cool. I like that card a lot.
It's like revealed top. If it's level 0, stock it. If you have 4 or more others, stock it. Wonderful. Okay.
Alright. Shall we move on to the next card?
Moving on.
It's a bunch of climaxes, and then we move on to the first red double R.
Cool. I already have.
Yep, so, this is a slap in the face to everyone who plays a red waifu deck. It's a 1/0 Kotori Minami.
Oh, wait,
it is a 1/0/2/5. When this becomes reversed, if the level it's a level 1 bomb.
Wait and a second. Why does it feel like we missed the card?
Because we didn't.
What? We didn't.
Number 12? What is this translation?
It's a climax.
Oh, it is a climax.
Climaxes.
I can't read anything.
There are three versions.
Dude, the text just throws me off now.
You'll live. So Kotori Minami is a 1-0 bomb, and it has the startup ability of 1 cost, ditch a climax card from your hand, choose a character in your waiting room, and add it to your hand. So I think this card is actually really good.
This card is very good.
There, we found it. Yeah, I got there. Agreed.
My favorite part is how there's already a 1-0 Kotori that is a level 1.
Well,
it has an irrelevant climax combo. Something.
Yeah, this one actually does something, which is nice.
But that one, didn't that one have like 500 more power or something?
It was 3k.
It was 3k? Oh boy.
So, the only awkward thing about really low power level 1 bombs is that sometimes they'll just ram a level 0 into it.
Yeah.
That's true. And that's, yeah.
That's
why I feel people are kind of moving away from.
A comparison is to a 3k level 1 bomb. So
they definitely get bigger than 3k.
I think this card is just really good.
No, that's this card is really solid. I don't like, to a certain extent, that her secondary effect is a startup. I think the auto version is way better, but
I think the auto version is better because the auto version usually doesn't cost stock. But at the same time, most cards with that ability usually have some other drawback or aren't put on a good body, like a 1-0 bomb.
And then there's the Marika from...
That card is different, though.
That's very different. Let's not go there.
It's an amazing card, yeah.
Dang.
But it's just really good and underrated, even though people rate it highly. It's still underrated.
Your face when Nisekoi cards, like, from over a year and a half ago, are still freaking dumb.
This card is good.
Yeah, this card's good.
Well, Nisekoi was supposedly run by someone different, so yeah.
Reasons. Yeah.
Didn't he like get fired or something?
She apparently got.
She.
Whatever.
I don't know. I just assumed he.
Can I just point out that the card of the day from English Bushi Road is misspelt?
Beautiful.
That happens a lot.
Yeah, it's just new.
Look, the word
prim, volume two.
Like primp and proper, that's not the phrase. It's prim and proper.
Primp?
Maybe they actually meant to say primp.
Primp is a verb. Primp is not an adjective.
Okay, moving forward.
Oh, I can talk about this card because I play this deck. So this is Angelic Angel.
damn it.
Chihaya Sonoda?
What's her name? Chihaya
what? Chihaya Sonoda?
Yes.
Chihaya Sonoda.
Sonoda.
Okay, so this is Angelic Angel Kisaragi Chihaya. It's a 1-0. It's a 1-0 3K.
Trying to keep a straight face is hard, isn't it, guys?
Yeah, it's a 1-0. It's a 1-0 3K that gives all of your other music characters 500 power. This seems awfully familiar, and then has the secondary ability of pay 1, clock your top deck, choose a character in your waiting room, and add it to your hand.
Cool. It's Taketsubo except salvage instead of search.
And it's level 1 instead of level 0.
And it's global 5 instead of 5. It's actually what kind of kills
the card.
It's also global support, which is all right.
It's also global 5 as opposed to frontal 5. I honestly don't think this card is, like, worthwhile at level 1.
Do you know what other 1-0 Chihaya with global 500 and a 1-cost tap ability is commonly played?
What?
The Brainstorm.
Yes,
sir. Infamous Brainstorm.
The Brainstorm's 3K.
I think I prefer the Brainstorm.
I do because it
feels
better.
You don't take pain. Yeah, no, like, this card is playable because the Umi deck tries to wall up a little at level 1.
Do you want me to give you the waifu rating?
I'll go waifu rating as well.
I don't even think it's playable in the, like, the mono Chihaya deck.
Oh.
Does the waifu deck even need this card?
No, it does
not.
You've got the Brainstorm, and you've got the 0-0 support. There's no reason to run this, in my
opinion. Right, right.
It's just kind of, in a way, it's kind of unnecessary. You can avoid. Actually, yeah, give it.
I'll
call it niche at best.
It's niche because it still does something that no other card does, but I don't think I personally would run this. It would actually streamline your level 1 because. It
would make it all red, I would think.
It is all red.
Well, unless you could play the Clock Encore.
Yeah, the Clock Encore is the other card, but I don't know if I would play that personally.
Meh is not a rating, but meh is what I give this card.
Very well.
Oh, well.
Okay.
Next card. Sunny Day Song, Honkers, Conkers. 3-2, 10k.
Too much text.
Yeah, lots of text. So discard, when it's placed from hand to stage, check the top card of your deck. If it's a music character, deal 1 damage. This is an effect that already exists on the Chihaya card, I'm pretty sure.
Yes, I have too.
And that card has a universal ability, something to do with nuking level zeros, I don't remember.
Pay 1, risk 2 to nuke level 0 in the front row.
Sure.
Jesus front Christ.
Row.
What?
When...
I believe it was front row, I that's what I'm recalling as.
This yeah. card sounds
no one can
atrocious.
Correct me on that.
Yeah. So
I'm sure when... I remember calling it atrocious when we went over it.
So when Sunny Day Song is placed into your climax zone, Sunny Day Song's a red stock soul, I think.
Yes.
If this is in the front row, all of your characters gain a massive 500 power.
Oh man.
And the ability. When the battle opponent of this reversed, you may choose a character in your waiting room, add it to hand. So it turns all of your cards into on reverse salvages for free.
At level three,
and I'm
as an on reverse. Which
and
is
they, it's a stock soul, so they don't even get power. Like just the 500.
No.
Is there a way to cheat this card in at level two?
No.
Oh, unfortunate. Well, this card is bondable, I believe.
It is.
Bondable yep. does yeah. not matter yeah. for me on level threes, because like all that means is you paid one stock to get something to clock next turn.
I guess, but it also means you can bond at level two and have it there.
Oh man, I forgot. People gotta start running that Tirju in their Yami decks just so they can play around Bakemono.
I mean, there's a difference there, though, because that card at least is relevant traits. And this card is, I don't know, like, Yami digs itself. This one doesn't.
Well, Nanda's making a joke about running bonders for the sake of bonders.
Okay, sure.
So
first we give this more of a waifu rating, just simply because it would give Honka another finisher outside of the top decker healer from SIF2. The Karmic combo has something else to be
is there a
desired.
Way to easily fix the top of your deck in Love Life?
I'm sure there's a scry somewhere.
Easily? As in like a waifu context, or like in general?
In general.
Are lots of scry cards.
In general, there are a lot of scry cards.
But then why would you be running this and not the Chihaya?
There is actually a specific Chihaya which scries. I know because I play it.
Yeah, it's a 2/1. I in front, they get level 3 characters get 2k.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
An on play scry.
I'm gonna give the card playable, and I think that's a little bit generous.
It's niche because I think it's outclassed by the Chihaya.
I'm being very generous with my rating here.
Fair enough. You're not very generous with your other ratings, though.
No, not usually.
Alright.
Moving
so
on. This
next card, Sunny Day Song, Kisaragi Chihaya. This is a 2-1 counter.
Is that actually her name? No, I'm talking about, like, the Chihaya name. I know what this name is, because I'm looking at the translation.
Yeah, it's Kisaragi Chihaya, I'm pretty sure.
Okay, cool. I don't really know anything about idols.
It's a 2-5 counter, which
means
it has...
I think Awful just try to have a whole argument with me about how they're the same character.
Yeah, they are the same character.
You mean you're talking about Neo Akiyama, right?
Yeah.
Now I'm just going to go over there and shoot you.
I like Neo Akiyama.
I do too.
When you use the backup of this, if you have a music character, i.e., well, how can you... Maybe if... How can you not have a music character when you play this counter? Let's ignore that.
You have
but
to have...
Maybe you're prepping for the death gun, like, heals.
You intentionally picked a llama deck. You're playing this on llama deck.
How did you counter if you have no characters? And, look, okay, sure. If it's the mono alpaca deck, right. But... Okay, like, mono alpaca and season 1 Imoto's dot deck.
Exactly.
Alright, fine.
And I think Nico's mom is a character or something, I don't know.
If that is the case, you don't get to pay this cost.
Are there even enough cards to make a season 1 Imoto's deck? That's actually kind of...
Dear God.
Defining a deck.
We're devolving. We're devolving very fast.
It is a 2-1. When you have a music character, you may pay cost. If you do, clock your... Like, the cost is clock your top deck. And if you do that, you get to reshuffle your library.
Cool. So it's like a free refresh, except it's actually just regular refreshing.
I disagree, because the important distinction is that you remove a card from your deck, which hopefully wasn't a climax.
The and important distinction is you get to choose when to do this.
Yeah, so you don't take refresh damage, and you put one more card into your clock, which
Well, you do take refresh damage. You just took it before refreshing.
This is true, yeah.
You took a damage instead of actually get refresh damage, yes. Like against mechanics. There we go.
You still took refresh damage.
No, you didn't actually take damage. You
clock.
It's not cancelable damage. So this card is useful because it improves your compression very, very slightly using your pre-refresh deck as opposed to your post-refresh deck, which sounds like a misnomer. But if you can confirm that the rest of your deck is nothing but
damage,
then this actually saves you damage in the long run. So there's one situation where it'd be useful. I don't know. I don't know if I'd run this. I probably wouldn't, because it's just such a niche effect, and the 3K can be...
Yeah, it is definitely niche.
Of note, this does go back into your deck.
Yes, this goes back into the deck because you have to discard the card beforehand.
Which, in fact, means that the compression was completely neutral, because you also had to pay out that stock.
I mean, compare this to other refresh backups.
Yeah, exactly. Like,
most refresh backups are a total of 3 stock. 1 to do the backup and then an additional 2 to refresh.
Yes, and then the card itself.
And in that case, you're usually paying the 2 to functionally heal on your refresh counter.
I guess that's
true. Which is pretty good.
Yeah, that's fair.
If that's the case, then these all kind of even up, but the healing effect from the other counter is just really big.
I'm going to give the card a niche rating.
I think it's niche as well, because it does something nothing else does. I just don't think it does it frequently enough.
No. I find this effect to be kind of underwhelming. It's just going through it in my head. It's like not that much better than the refreshing, which means it only has corner case applications. It has only corner case applications.
It only ever works well in a few cases, and those cases don't come along often enough. That doesn't make it a bad card.
When your opponent is girlfriends and they play that forced refresh card and you have this in your hand, you're going to laugh at them.
I suppose, but they still got damage out of it.
Yes, they got 1 damage. They got 1 uncancelable
damage.
Uncancelable damage.
Love Life also has this card, for the record.
Yes.
Yes, Love Life does have this card.
Love Life has the forced...
Yes.
Anyway, that's my rating. We can move on to the next card if you want. So, Angelic Angel, Honoka Kosaka, it's 2/1/4/5. It is a level assist, so gives characters in front X power, where X is 500 times that character's level. And 1 cost, discard a climax card from your waiting room as a startup cost. We saw this not long ago, didn't we? This is just Kotori's effect.
Yes.
1 cost, discard a climax card from your hand to waiting room, choose a character in waiting room and add it to your hand.
The level 1 bomb is better.
Yes.
For that purpose, sure, yes.
I'm pretty sure I would play level 1 bomb over this card, even in a Hanukkah waifu deck.
Are they both Hanukkah?
You'll play a Kotori bomb in a Hanukkah waifu deck.
Because I don't think this card is good at all.
Okay.
Is it better, Hanukkah? Haha, Onoka support later.
Yeah, I'm not too fond of this card myself, even in Onoka waifu. Like,
this card's
it's just good for art.
I think it's just like a very. Oh, I'll say. I think this card's bad.
Someone, somewhere, out there, Audrey is hearing this and dying.
I'm sorry, Audrey. So I'm sorry. I don't know if Honoka actually has a better support that has the word Honoka in name, but.
I personally like image change Honoka from SIF to over this. It's a 1,000 global and has the effect of when a character gets reversed in battle, you can give another one of your characters plus 1k until end of turn.
It's a 2/1, right?
That sounds better than this card.
It is better than this card.
Much better,
yeah. Like this card's
and there's another one later on that I think is a little better than what this does. I assume you'll want to use this effect multiple times in a game anyway.
Unless you're like about to refresh, I really don't want to use this card.
I think fixing is nice, but surely Honoka has some other discard outlets.
Yes, there was one from, again, Volume 2, Astonishing Truth Homoko. On play, discard a climax to Salvation Homoko.
That's way better than this.
Any music. Sorry, yeah. Salvation's any music, but there are better
ones. We're talking about waifu decks right now, right?
Yeah.
Well, even in, yeah, like, if we talk about waifu decks, saying Honoka from Love Live 1, from Love Live 2.
This card doesn't even get the waifu rating. This card just gets the bad rating.
Oh, it's bad.
I don't think I can give this card a good rating.
No. It's not salvageable.
Yeah.
Sorry.
No.
I know.
No.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Moving on. I'm done. I'm done.
Oh, no, you're not done yet.
No, I'm already upset.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That just... I was stunned for a moment there. Angelic Angel Kotori Min. I'm just going to go call her Bird. Angelic Angel Bird.
That's fine.
217k. When this attacks, if the level of the character opposite this is 3 or higher, this gains 3k, no, 6k for the turn. When this attacks, if we are a single light, so the super climax that has bar, pants, and gate is in the climax zone, you may pay 1. If you do, deal 1 damage to your opponent.
Cool.
It's actually a pretty serviceable card, if you ask me.
Yeah, it's not bad.
It's playable.
14k?
It's 14k and gets the
14K.
Ping.
14k. Yeah.
Don't care about climax. It gets that first ability regardless of climax.
I'm assuming you're going to put this in front of one of the early plays.
No, you put it in front of one of the level 1s. What do you think?
Do both.
No, play for level 0. Get out of here. You people are awful.
This card is fine. I think it's playable. I don't think it's great because, like, this is a level 3 killer with a lot of oomph behind it.
Sure.
But I think it's playable because it combos with
the super climax.
Yeah. And I guess
that's what pushed it over the edge for me.
And
I'm giving the card playable just because what is the word I'm looking for? Dang, I'm forgetting. I'm blanking on words. I dislike this card effect a lot.
Yeah, we know you hate it. I think it's okay. It's not the worst thing ever.
So that's why it loses points.
Sure.
Now, William, let me try to persuade you a little bit here. And maybe you can try to bump this up from leash to maybe even waifu. What if I tell you that Kokari does have an auto-type burn combo, but it requires more payment. Where it's with either a plus 2 soul or a gate.
I'm already sold on plus 2 soul.
Pay 1. Pay 1, discard a card from your hand to burn 1. As you get something like 2k until end of opponent's next turn.
Does she draw 2? Ditch 1?
No, she's a level 2 1. That's the only ability she has.
That is awful.
can you move it up to playable? Can we peer pressure you into saying this is playable?
No. Or at least waifu?
I'm not budging on this.
Why? It's fine.
Don't be unreasonable, man.
I'm not pushing on this. Moving on.
Being unreasonable.
As the person in control of the text, moving on.
So he saith, next card is...
Does it was decreed.
Sunny Day Song, Bird, 00500, assist, give 500 in front, and 1 cost. Swap the top card of your opponent's library with a card in their waiting room. Well, technically, it's 1 cost. Put the top card of your opponent's library in the waiting room and choose a card in your opponent's waiting room and put it on top of the library.
So cool. Pay 1, put a damage on top of their deck.
Exactly. But don't you can only do it once because if you do it again, then you'll just put the same card back.
Pretty evil, actually. I'd love to just see like a 1 of in my deck because sometimes they're at 3-6 and I want to really make sure they're dead.
I think this card is playable.
I would play this.
I would call this Nish, or I would call this Nish, because it's a better card. It's an SIF card that does something similar. Well, okay, it does the same thing as that act ability, but it has, I'm pretty sure Thomas would agree with me on this.
It has the
when a character gets reversed in battle, give another character plus 1k until end of turn.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think the other one's better.
I guess better than 500 assists.
I would still say this card is playable. I don't know.
I think it's playable.
There are times
I don't hate this card.
Where you want to put one damage on top of their deck, exactly one. And this card will get you there.
And Kotori, like I just mentioned, does the same exact thing.
This card is fine.
Is it?
I think it's somewhat redundant.
Yeah.
Sure, I guess. I think this card is fine. Shall we move on?
Yep.
It will agree to disagree.
Sunny Day Song, Yukiho Kosaka. I have to assume that's her little sister.
Honoka's sister, yes.
Honoka's sister.
The one with the Kosaka name, yes.
Yeah.
Sucker. When this is placed, this is 0/0, it's 1k. When it's placed from hand to stage, you may pay 2. If you do, salvage your character. And when this attacks, choose another character. That character gains 1k at 1 level for the turn. So, riddle me this. Why aren't people just playing this card instead of that overpriced LE promo?
Who knows?
No one knows! It's because it's not green or blue.
I guess.
That's the reason.
I suppose.
I'm making
a pseudo joke here.
You're not, though, because you're actually making a good point. It's not gettable by Akatsuki, whereas the Nico support and that promo LER.
I think because of the fact that your deck has Akatsuki's and it does enforce a certain level of deck construction,
it does encourage you to run more.
This is hardly something you run in multiples, right? It's literally just something like...
Probably like a 2 of tech, max?
Not even. This is actually a 1 of, maybe.
This is a 1 of.
Are we talking about the plus salvage profile or the...
We're talking about the card on the field.
Okay.
The card on the screen, rather. I don't hate this card. I think it's playable.
It's playable.
Playable.
It's nice.
What does the promo do?
I don't like...
It literally does the second effect, but on play.
Come and play, give 1k and 1 level.
The main reason is like, one thing it's an LA card and it's a green card.
Is that card more or less expensive than the Mekon promo?
It's
less.
Alright.
980 yen on UUK West.
It's like 980 yen. Yeah.
Making sure, because that Mekon promo was like $30.
That was because there's
people are suckers.
No, it's because there's 2 in a case, and oh yeah, you're right. People are suckers.
Because people feel the need to run that card.
Japanese players think it's the only viable card.
I mean, it wasn't just Japanese players. Okay.
It was people on both sides of the.
Thanks, foreign.
West Coast. See, I got 3 of them, and I just don't care.
I don't even run them.
I got them for cheap. I got them for cheap, too.
I got them cheap as well.
I didn't bother to purchase them because I didn't think I needed them.
Next card is another Yukiho. This is the bond to Honoka. Right. I guess you play it if you play that Honoka. Maybe. I don't even know if you play this if you play that Honoka.
I'm not even going to update the ratings.
I'm not even going to update the ratings.
So this is the bone they threw to all of those. I don't remember the name of this group.
Arise.
To the Arise people. And then you read the cards and realize they didn't throw you a bone at all. They just don't like you guys. Sunny Day Song.
They all have the same effect.
We're going to review all of them at the same time.
Cool.
Because they all do the same game, but for
different
games.
Are these a cool Legion art? They're not even cool Legion art.
No.
Kind of are.
One
second. I gotta put all the text on top of each other.
No, you don't. Because there are 3 Arise cards. They're all 002Ks. And they all give 1K to the others.
Look at this. It's just like stacked on top of each other. Now I can just like flash through the 3.
Congrats. So Tsubasa Kira, Eren Natoto, and Anju Yuki. They're all the same card, except they pump the other 2 of the trio.
Nice! I saw that Yukiho, dude.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
How are you going too fast?
Super niche.
Not even niche.
No, it's just okay, niche.
It's only niche because the Arise deck has nothing else to play.
Not even niche.
No, this is bad.
Not even niche.
You don't get to do your Arise combo if you play nonsense like this.
Fine. It's bad.
What? No, you already said niche. I'm leaving it there so you can feel bad about your decision.
I actually want to burn all the ones that I have.
We're gonna burn all of them.
Let's be honest, yeah, video of it.
Put it. We'll put it on
let's
top tier tiers.
Let's be honest here, guys. I think, like, I don't know about y'all, but I think Honka was the only one who actually looked good in a Sunny Gay Song outfit.
I watched the movie and don't remember anything about it.
I did not watch the movie. And
I did not like that song, actually.
Well, I'm not talking about the song, right? I'm talking about the outfit.
I just wasn't paying attention because I didn't like the song.
We're going to move on from bad cards.
I like Boku no Hikari much better.
I thought you were about to say Boku too. No Pico.
I was also already there.
You are awful. Can we go talk about this card, guys?
Future
this
style.
This card pains me. This card pains
Oh,
me.
Man, this card is so tragic.
Wow. Holy God.
This card pains me.
This card, though, 0025.
I cry every cam.
So, when this is played, it's a level 0 bomb, first and foremost, which is good, right? It's a 2-5 level 0 bomb, which is above average, right?
What's the downside? Means, well, it's on the screen, but,
when this is placed from hand to stage, if you have no other music characters, it dies.
Beautiful.
Horrible. This is like the... it's like that Elizabeth from Persona, except it's a bomb.
You mean it's bad?
I mean, it kills itself every time you play it.
Wonderful. I think this card is awful.
But at least the Elizabeth tells you what your like top card's going to be, right?
No, it doesn't. It mills.
Oh, that's right.
That card mills one, actually. That makes it better than this one.
This card gets... It gets one step down from bad. It goes straight to awful.
I don't think it's awful, actually. I think it's
fine.
It's fine in the late game. It takes a really... bad series of events for this to totally screw you over, i.e. this being the only level 0 in your hand, and hopefully that doesn't happen very often.
There are other level 0 bombs, right?
I still think...
Yes, there's an anti-runner bomb! Why would you run this?
He's right, there's a bird anti-runner bomb, and there's an Umi that pops level 0.
Do you want me to switch you back to off?
There's even a better Hanukkah.
Better Honker. Big outfit honker.
Okay, you know what? Fine. There is no niche for a 2-5 bomb because it's a 2-5 bomb. Who cares? It is a bad card because it just doesn't do anything. But the effect is not as bad as you guys say. It's just it's bad for other reasons.
Okay. Sure.
I don't think the effect is that bad either. It's just like
I'm trolling with my right to do text.
Even if you were making a waifu deck, this is not the option you'd go for.
No, this card is awful.
Oh, yeah.
We're just gonna move on. I'm done with this card already.
Yep, so next card is Future Style Kisaragi Chihaya. It's a 1-0-5K. When this attacks, if Future Style is in the Climax Zone, so Future Style is this 2K1 soul, right?
Yeah.
I remember there being a lot of fuss about how this is bad because it's a 2K1 soul.
You may
if you do, you may salvage a character, and then you may look at the top card of your library and either put it on top or in the waiting room.
This card isn't bad.
That's fine.
It doesn't have a... It
sounds...
Like, I would not play this card.
Not even in your Chihaya deck?
Well,
no, I wouldn't.
You do know the Mio Akiyama deck better than I do, so...
The Chihaya deck has a 1-1 salvage combo as well. It's with a gate.
That's true. Yeah.
And it walls. Yeah, that one not only walls. Yeah, it has the overall cost down, but it also walls. Yeah. And the only requirement for it to be 7-5 is that you need one of the four of the threes in your deck to be your experience, which is easy enough. So I don't think this card has a role in the Chihaya deck at all.
I just like this card. I think it's really cool.
It's hangy.
I'm not saying it's like save the card. I just think
Does
it's
anyone cool. want to give it a rating that isn't niche, or can I just start typing this in?
I've got it as bad.
Can I call it cool?
Sure.
Cool as the ocean.
Omega.
I blacked out again. I'm sorry. That was okay. Terrible. You should all feel terrible. Next card is...
I always feel terrible.
I don't even understand. I was
making
a joke about
me. So, thank you, card.
So the
I'm
next card
not
is
even updating the rating.
Totally not future Hanukkah. 2-1-5K. all your
other... spoiler tag for this video, right?
Sorry?
We're going to have a spoiler tag for this, are we?
Are you kidding? It's been like everyone who cares about Love Live in the world, and some people don't care about it, like me, have seen the movie. And most of those people have seen it more than once because they want more signboards or something.
Or they watched the movie and were just like completely clueless, and now they just found out.
So, what is the Love Live movie about?
It's about school idols.
They go to America?
They go to America, promote school idols, and then Sunrise Bullshit. Chaos. Sunrise Bullshit happens.
It's basically
actually based on the Chaos movie, yeah.
It's set
with Chaos. With Sunrise Shenanigans. Okay, Sunrise Shenanigans happen.
Okay.
So this card is a global 1K to Hanukkah, and one cost to tap two music characters. When this is placed from hand to stage, you may pay cost. If you do, salvage a Hanukkah in your waiting room and add it to hand.
I think
waifu reading.
It's waifu. It's waifu.
This is niche, yeah. You guys can keep saying waifu. They mean the same thing as niche.
Wow. Oh, okay then. I can.
That's not well.
It doesn't hurt. Doesn't really matter.
No. I'm gonna go
ahead. I like that it's just called female singer, though.
Oh man.
Speaking of female singer, the Gank Gary sing.
Oh man. Okay. The only event in the set so far.
So this is a 1/1. Find the answer.
It's something like that.
It is. So it's got the same stupid text. If you have no music characters, you can't play this. So it's not actually text. And choose a cost one or lower character in your opponent's back row and put it in the waiting room.
I think it's playable.
I think that you would rather play the 2/1 Umi card.
You know, like, the fact that this is a 1/1 makes it that much better.
I guess, but the Umi card kills anything.
He runs a cost two supports that you like to kill in the back.
I think getting rid of back in this game early on is very valuable. It's why people fear Hopple from Conclave Abyssals.
I don't fear
the 1/0.
You know, I think I agree with you, actually. I think I agree.
Like, taking out back row is very important, especially in this day and age of the game. A lot of decks rely on certain back row cards.
Mm-hmm.
What does that mean? What does that do again? It's like
Just takes out a level 2 or lower character anywhere on board.
I mean, I guess
that's a restriction. You can't play unless having Umi character on board.
Yeah, that's the one.
I feel like you'd always play that card just to kill back row anyways.
Functionally speaking,
this is a 1/1, which makes I think that makes it that much more valuable.
Functionally speaking, this card is like always going to be able to kill something if they have a card in their back row. I can't think of any decks that run 2/2 back row supports anymore.
The real question.
Long Horizon.
Nothing.
Congratulations, you found a 1/1.
The real question about this card is if we're going by the Illinois. I don't know the Illiana. Waifu deck construction rules. Can you put this in a Hanukkah deck?
I would at least count her as an accessory character.
Would you? But does it count as Hanukkah? It's not. It hasn't been confirmed that this is Hanukkah, but it's so obvious.
I would personally rule it as just okay in a Hanukkah deck.
Where's Audrey? Let's get Audrey.
Yes, we can clearly get Audrey when it's like.
We can tap
it. It's like 2 a.m. there.
Is it? Oh yeah, it would be, wouldn't it? Anyway, yes. let's move on because that was the important point that we couldn't come to a consensus, and we're up to blue now, aren't we?
Yep.
I believe so.
So blue cards. First blue card. Hello, count the stars, Rin Hoshizora. I want to ask, where did she get that outfit from? The one thing that sticks out to me about the movie is that she randomly got a new outfit when this song started. And it completely confused me.
Well, basically...
And so, get a third years from ? Okay.
Basically, someone wasn't paying attention to continuity and hoped people wouldn't notice.
Sure, let's go with that.
I mean, it's a musical type movie, but it's not really going to OSD.
Realistically, they probably animated the sequence before they animated the preceding sequences.
We're not giving this card enough credit. It's the cheapest double R on Yute, and I think they're completely wrong because this card is better.
I think it's
I expect this card to have been at least double of what Yute plus.
What climax card is does it combo with? Holy Jesus! This card is great.
Yeah, this card is great.
It's effing great.
This card is actually good.
It's so underrated. I actually don't understand what Love Life players are thinking.
I agree.
They talk about this.
This
card.
Might actually be the superior Mill 4 card.
This is.
Yes.
Oh my goodness. So like, yeah, this so anyway, is your level just, 1 combo.
It is as.
No, you run both. Oh.
Yeah, exactly.
Run both for all the milling. You get
so you get so you get your advantage at level 1, then you get incidental advantage by playing random stock souls after that. Mm. Oh man.
It's because you freaking care. You don't care.
So this card is
in your front row.
It has a whole bunch of really good things going for it. So in case you can't read,
That's so rude. So
I'm like, do I have to talk about the effects because now it's on screen?
Yes, and... because there are some people who just listen.
Yeah. So sure, it's an assist 500, a 0/0/500 power, which means it gets popped by Kaiki. When
heaven forbid.
When Hello Counter Stars, which is a blue stock soul, is placed in the climax zone, if there are five or more cards in stock, so you need four stock plus the stock from stock soul, look it up to four cards from the top of your deck and search for up to one music character, reveal it, add it to hand, and put the rest in the waiting room. The reason we're talking about how good this card is because it's very easy to get fulfilled a five stock requirement. And you might want to play Stock Soul anyway. This gives you a milling effect that doesn't require you to reverse anything and gets you advantage, assuming you have more than one. And it's on a Rin card, which works well with Lovewing Bell, which is...
And it's in blue, which means that your blue Katsuki is good.
Completely costless as well. Pretty solid.
Oh my god. It's just value on value on value on more value.
It's a really solid card, I think.
It's a really, really good card. Yeah.
So the next card is, I guess, I'm giving this card a good rating. I almost want to call it meta simply because it works with Lovewing Bell.
I don't want to give like any card a meta rating at all in this set
that
so
is,
far.
That is my.
Oh, favorite. You skipped a card.
I skipped a Honeyo. Oh, by the way,
I'm missing a card.
You skipped a card, man.
Oh, you're missing the card.
Wow.
That up so much.
That card is against this card.
Yo,
so,
give me a minute.
When we do get to Honeyo, I'm gonna tag someone else in and go prepare dinner. Because someone wants to talk about Honeyo.
We'll just do 37 first, I guess.
Oh, well, then I guess...
Talking man now.
37? You mean 36, right?
What? No, this is 36.
No, he somehow was missing 30.
This is 36.
I'm missing 35.
Okay, well, I'm going to tag in who wants to talk about Honeyo. This is Teru. He's been on our cast
sure.
now. Then.
Okay.
Hello, this is Teru.
Okay, have fun. I'm going to go make food.
All right. Shall I read it? Or...
I'll read it. If your opponent has a level 3 or higher character, this gets minus one level in hand.
It's a card first.
Oh, okay. Angelic Angel. What is her nickname?
Koizumi Rice.
Rice.
All right,
oh,
there
Rice,
we go.
You wanna be fucking...
Rice Queen.
Angelic Angel
fucking
Rice.
Disrespectful like that, bro?
Yes.
Damn.
If your opponent is level 3 or higher character, this gets minus 1 level in your hand. If you have 3 or more other music characters, this card is an 10-5. At the beginning of your opponent's draw phase, you get to give one of your characters 4k power for the turn. Alright.
If it's in the front row.
If it's in the front row.
I think,
Good card.
Yeah, you're gonna put this in your back row.
Well, it's great.
Good card.
It's good.
This is a very good card.
Almost everyone plays advanced summoning level 3, let's be honest. Almost
this
everyone.
This is also the only Saya clone that is 10-5 base.
And you'll also, probably just beat the decks that don't have her.
Okay, does Miyu not get that big? Or is Miyu, base 10? I don't remember.
Miyu is Ilya. Base 9-5.
Does she get power? No.
Well, she doesn't.
Which I think is just a slightly easy way to come out.
Yeah, you just clock level zero and you get her.
Okay, easy.
Alright, now that I've corrected my mistakes and Alpha's still gone, poor Lychee.
Are you just gonna skip that card? Or?
No, we're going back now.
We gotta talk about it. We gotta talk.
Why would
about
you skip
card?
The Maki?
There.
This card.
We're back.
So emo swing is a really good card because
it got banned because it doesn't minus you and gives you two cards in your hand.
It just got removed. Let's skip from 70 to 72, just like how we skip from 30.
No, but you see, we went back. Okay, we are a single light Maki Nishikino. I don't even know. 1-0, 4,500 power. When the battle opponent of this becomes reversed, if we are a single light is in your climax zone, that is the same climax, I believe, as the card above it.
No, it's the super climax.
It's
the gold bar
pet. Super
climax.
The gold
bar pet. Yeah, all right.
If the super climax is in your climax zone, look at top four. Add a card to your hand. Add a music card to your hand.
Not any card.
And then you give a card one pay power. Oh, if only.
Oh yeah, that's true.
So,
man, that'd be so sweet.
Yeah. when this card reverses the battle opponent. So basically, it's combos with 1k1, so it's 5-5 there. It has the tap one of your back row or tap any character or music character to give it 1,000 power, so it gets another 1,000 power from there. And when you reverse things, you also get to assign 1,000 power. So it's just like the card from Cinderella Girls with this extra bit of text here.
But why does it like boost 1k instead of 2k? Like,
it's to the end of the opponent's turn.
It's the end of opponent's turn, not Minami was only until end of your turn.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
You're gonna be able to still get particular power when you play a climax in general.
So
I think this gets bigger than Miami in the first swing, though.
Yes, because you can tap back rows to pump it by 1,000.
Well, also because of the Nico support we mentioned a long time ago.
Because you can use Nico with the gold bar version.
Yes. So you can on the weakest lane, I guess, with only one Nico, you could get 6,500 power, 7,500 power on the first attack.
Which is fine.
But if you have two Nikos, oh man.
Then you probably spread the world.
Chill.
Actually, 85, because you probably tap that Niko to give this card another 1,000 power. So, 85 is still just short of that classic wall deck number, but no, this card is good.
Oh my lord.
I've committed to having one meta card a set, and I think this might have to be it.
Yeah, I think so too.
It's a bit sad because I honestly like a lot more cards in this set better than this one, but
I think the Rin support is like better, but oh well.
No, this card is really good. Terror now gets a slot.
Yay. Oh, you just think I think this card is good? What the fuck is your problem, man?
My call might just drop. Wow, language.
What the heck is your problem?
This isn't the Abyssal's cast anymore. We have to be child friendly.
Oh, no one told me. You just said you were going to tag me in.
Well, I did actually go need to.
Yes, it is a good card.
Defrost.
Okay, fine. It's probably meta. I think the Rin is cooler though. If I were to,
I like the level zero
between
Rin
double rares.
Better.
I think the Rin is way cooler, but I don't know if it's better. Also, my Skype is threatening to drop, so if it drops, continue without me.
Alrighty, Ripperino.
I think the numbers on this aren't super impressive, but whatever. It's still gonna reverse stuff because like Mekon can reverse stuff.
Yeah, if Mekon can reverse.
Kokomi can reverse stuff is the better statement to make.
If Mekon can reverse things, this can reverse things. That's basically all there is to it. We're gonna
We're
gonna skip.
Yo, we're not even gonna rate. We're not even gonna rate the early play.
I didn't put the numbers down, but we all said good, I believe.
Okay, yeah, sure.
I concur. That's the rating I had for it. It's good.
Yeah, just as long as we spoon feed.
I mean, it's good, but it's only best if you run that other Nico assist, which people probably shouldn't run.
I don't know. It wouldn't if you wanted to run that level zero or level one.
Okay. That's a good point. I also think that level advanced numbers are so ubiquitous that you can just get away with running it and nothing else.
Yeah. Especially it's like your entire level two game.
Oh, you're talking about that Nico? Oh my god.
I know.
Really? Really?
I gotta talk about the tech, man.
Wasn't that the card you gave Nico Niche?
gotta rep the OG persona.
talking about like a card from the first set.
Oh, I don't even know anymore.
Tom knows, right? It's the one.
It's where a tap to give something a level.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
Dear.
So you do dank combos.
The kind of plays that were inspired by Charlotte.
Oh, when you say that.
Oh dear. Anyways, moving on.
Sunny Day Song, Rice Girl. This is her second brainstorm? What the hell?
It is. No. It's her first.
No, she's nope. Another one.
She has a sweet brainstorm.
That is an amazing brainstorm.
Wait, not stand. Oh, are you kidding me, guys?
I play that brainstorm with my standard deck. It's amazing.
Okay, I have. Okay, Thomas, or whatever we're calling you. I have a list of sweet things I have made not stand. including Marika and the Nagato climax combo heal on attack. Like, those are the two most notable things I've made not stand. And within the Nagato alien deck, the tap to search thing when he had climaxes in stock.
All right then.
I'm going to run this card over that card, whatever.
Wow.
I actually forgot about
that. Wow.
Dude, I want pluses. My plussing is being a wall, and my walls are shitty.
This card is a very typical brainstorm. Pay one, rest two characters. For every climax, you can search for a music character, yada yada.
This is objectively worse than the Index Brainstormer.
Because it doesn't die to Kaiki.
No.
Get fucking owned.
Savage.
Fucking owned.
Meta rating.
Oh.
He's unfortunately correct, and also the index brainstormer sucks because. Can you imagine what it'd be like if you could search for ESP characters?
Oh my heinous god!
You probably.
Oh yeah, this.
Like the ability to search Misakuro would make Misakuro an auto include.
Oh dear.
Maybe not as good as Toma.
What if it could search traitless cards?
Oh my god!
Yes, please give it to me.
Sweet.
What if it could search events?
All these index faggots.
Hey, 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 hey.
I was a regular faggot before index, thank you.
I had the deck.
I also owned the deck's pre-comeback campaign.
I also did.
Dang. So we're just all sad people who got, like, very excited.
I hate index.
This is really awkward. I don't.
I hate index. Did Rin explode?
Oh.
Oh.
Why do you hate Index?
Index?
Anyway, I think this card is incredibly redundant in a normal Love Live deck. Because this is like the 18th playable brainstorm. There's already like a blue brainstorm at level 0.
Isn't there
that
like,
is a search brainstorm.
Isn't there a blue one at like level 1 that does this except level 5? Or is that just green and yellow right now?
No, it's green and yellow.
There's
Red
a...
Which brainstorms.
There's a Rin brainstorm at level 0. That's like
yeah, that's the one I'm talking about.
Oh, okay.
And that one's, like, marginally better, because despite being a worse girl, Lovewing Bell is a pretty cool card to consider.
Did Ren die?
And also just...
He did die.
I have been revived.
Okay, so, can I talk about why I hate Index?
Sure.
Can we... Wait, isn't like, there going to be a video for this?
Series, deck, or character?
I guess we can do that in the recap video. The character, obviously.
The
deck is cancer. It's great.
I love the deck.
So, you know how you play, like, a Final Fantasy game, and you go and get a really useless MacGuffin?
Is Index that MacGuffin?
Index is like that MacGuffin, except she also eats your elixirs and ethers.
And she talks.
Well, and she constantly deals damage to you on the world map. And she's like Na'vi levels of, hey, listen to me, I have a calico cat, I'm cute. The entirety of Pixiv loves me, even though I am objectively terrible.
To be fair,
that's why I love her.
You weren't going to use those elixirs anyways.
You're right, I'm the sort of person who ends the game with like 7 elixirs and 4 mega elixirs and use them.
Like, you weren't going to use the elixirs anyways.
I feel like we kind of...
Who uses elixirs, man?
I use elixirs when you can make elixirs freely.
Alright, moving on.
Yeah, let's move on. So this is a Maki card.
As such, it gets an immediate good rating, because Maki is the goodest waifu.
as such,
so
it's
wrong.
A
it's
playable
hilarious.
Card.
This card is arse.
What? This
I
card
think
is fine.
It's better than her other 106k clock encore.
So what happens when you
card.
Get like five people on one call about Love Live?
But only three of them care about Love Live.
Yes, but
hey,
the other
have
two have to listen.
Deck.
Hey, what does that sound like?
This is playable.
This is not nearly as bad as the last time we did this.
This card is Sinon. It's
like
yeah.
this card. This
also
card was Saki. Definitely existed.
And Sinon is playable.
Is she?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm so
yeah.
down on that Sinon
I
card.
I mean,
it was playable before the Duisao set, but that makes it not playable now.
That's fair, I guess.
I don't even know what your filler cards in the SAO deck now are now.
I mean,
like,
I'm
I think
still
it's the 1-0 get just, big Kirito's.
I'm still
yeah,
giving this a playable rating just because like it is a playable card. But I'd imagine you have something better to play at 1-0, right?
I think this card is fine.
Having experience with the monkey deck,
playable.
I really like this card.
Yeah, in the monkey deck, this is pretty choice.
I think there's a better level one for the monkey deck coming up.
Not
oh, sure.
Look at
Jesus
cards here.
I guess.
Do you know what the Whatever, previous cost of 6k clock encore was?
Ooh, six cards in hand, boy.
You had a previous 6k clock encore?
Yeah, you
needed
six
cards
in
hand.
And you're complaining about it?
I've already moved on.
Oh, check your item master privilege.
I have already.
Persona is privilege.
What?
Wow, Persona is not privileged. Persona is suffering. Persona is middle of the road suffering.
What's back of the short bus suffering?
Persona player to check our privilege. This
hey man, like... I don't have good cards. I just have a bunch of middling cards.
Teru, if it's middle of the road suffering, what gets short back of the short bus suffering?
Fucking like Kanon and King of Fighters.
Kanon.
KOF is way better than the other two you listed.
Dude, KOF has Ash, okay?
KOF has games where it's, like, extremely amazing, and other games where you're just, like, you have two cards in hand at all time, and that's when you're brainstorming and plussing every turn.
I feel like we should probably start on blue sometime, because we always sidetrack and start being really not, like, we start being irrelevant when blue comes around.
It's because blue is usually the worst color in a set.
Is it?
Blue is the best color
in
this set.
It's almost always the last
Blue has best girl.
Angelic Angel Rin Hoshizora, 2/1/4/5. It's an assist that gives all level 3 in front 2k and that you draw drop when you play it.
I wouldn't
cool.
play it, but I like that it draw drops.
I like that it draw drops too, but you know what other level assist draw drops?
It's not even a level assist.
Yes, CL.
Yeah, the seal's better than this, I think. Because it's a level assist.
I like this card though.
I do. I like this card too. But like,
I personally prefer frontal 2K.
The seal is worse because like blue and multi-blood is super tragic.
Oh, so the seal is worse because she doesn't heal.
Sure.
That's right. That's...
Yeah.
I wouldn't even run this though.
Yeah, you wouldn't. Not when you have a double R support like the one above.
Alright,
she also
forward.
Has a level assist that has, like, an effect. I don't even remember what the effect
it's
is.
It's a climax
rush,
combo.
Oh, whoops. I like,
and no one runs the
no, totally.
Is it a climax combo?
No, it's rush 2, give a character plus. Don't give a character power. Give a character on reverse draw and drop.
See,
oh,
I think that's better than this.
Yeah.
Oh, what? I just realized what card is coming up next.
Oh, this card.
Oh, this card's so...
All the heals in the world.
Where's my gun?
Sorry, what's the lowest rating we can give a card?
So this card, Sunny Beat Song,
call it card shite?
It's a 001k. Why is it lower than 3k? This should be... That's
no, it's 4k. It's 4k.
Okay, thank you.
It is a typo on the translation.
Thank you, Heart of the Cards. It is a 4k. When this is placed from hand to the stage, your opponent may draw two cards. If so, they ditch two.
Amazing card! Wow!
Yosuke Bomb?
Oh, goodbye.
I play this card in my DC deck, except it's only a 500 power assist, and it's me who's drawing and dropping two, and I have to pay one, and I'm very happy about it. Why would you ever play this card?
That's nothing.
You know,
like this card.
Someone tried to justify this effect to me.
Okay,
well,
alright, wait.
By saying,
let,
like,
let,
oh,
let,
boy, you can play this the Forest Refresh is exactly what that person said to me.
No.
Boom.
You know what else is Refresh? Refresh? Punching them in the face.
The Happy Maker Rin also forces Refresh.
Bro, well, no. Force Refresh, then sack it to heal. Get money. Play Love Live.
Easy game.
Are you being paid by Bushiroad? Okay.
Can we just go to the next card?
Yes.
I cannot.
I'm not even putting a rating down. This card is that garbage.
Fluffy Alpaca Sun.
This card is better than the previous card.
Alpaca is a good deck, guys.
Hey, man, this card this card is hilarious. It has the music trait, and it doesn't have the animal trait. It has the animal trait, and doesn't have the music trait.
So, according to Heart of the Cards, this card's name is Sunny Day Song Rin Hoshizora, and it's a 4K power card. It's a 4-5, right?
That's the name of the card before.
No, there was a mix-up on Bushiro's official site on the card list.
Okay, here it is. According to Heart of the Cards, this card is... Yes. So according to Heart of the Cards, this card is a Music Trait 4K, which is the card before it. Oh, this is incredible. I freaking love Heart of the Cards sometimes.
So this is a 1... It's a 1-0-4-5 that gives... gets 500 per animal. So, one, why would you play this when you have the Ellie? And...
What, you don't like alpacas?
No.
Also, it doesn't have music trait. Oh. Ripperino, Skype call drops. We'll be right back. Alright, we're already back because I'm hosting now. Something about alpacas and...
So, like, in a very sick me sort of way, you could definitely play this with, like, old Hanayo cards.
Does Hanayo have animal trait?
I'll give this the alpaca.
Her older cards have animal trait, but, like, her older cards are also kind of terrible.
I would not recommend playing this card unless you are extraordinarily...
There's really no point other than it's like we need to make another alpaca that doesn't pay for the stock cost of a change effect.
I'm giving it the meme rating.
That's pretty accurate.
Alpaca rating.
That echo. Did anyone else see that, or is that just
no? It's just me and you. It's just me and you.
That would have made you giving ratings so awesome. Unfortunate.
The verb.
Okay, so this is kill the animals rating. We gotta go fast.
Kill the animals.
AGDQ.
Did you donate to kill the animals?
I've donated most years leading up to last year.
Did you not donate this year?
No, I didn't because I didn't get to watch AGDQ this year.
Ah, rip. Well, you got SGDQ to look forward to then.
Mm-hmm. I think we can just skip. This card is actually just...
It's bad. I'm moving on.
I don't think it's bad. I just
Which
don't
card?
The alpaca 6/5.
Oh,
is it actually bad? Like, is the animal card pool that shallow?
Yes.
It's literally old Hanayo cards. Like, Love Live Volume 2, she might not even have the animal trait anymore.
Alright, I'm getting so many Skype alerts now. I need to turn this off.
You should invite Rin.
Oh, wait, why isn't Rin in here?
He got kicked because...
Something wants to call. Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Oh, it's because he's not in my contacts.
That is an awkward... Can I add to a call?
You can, but he can't get into the conference call unless... there are too many people in this chat. All right, he's been added. Just tell him to rejoin the chat when he accepts my request, and we can move on to this Rin card. I think it's Rin. No, it's Maki.
Okay, so
this is the card that I alluded to, which is a good card. It's the card that I talked about in Doge Days being really good, and I was validated because, like, 3 shop tournaments were won by people running multiples of this. It's a 1/1/4/5. Well, the Dog Days one was 1/1/5K, but whatever. This card has, if the cost of the character opposite this is 0 or lower, this gains 1 level and 3/5 power. So what this card does is it completely invalidates all level 1 bombs, and it mostly invalidates all 1-0 plus in combos, including but not limited to Mikan, Hibiki, Kokomi, It doesn't invalidate Rin because that one doesn't matter. It mostly invalidates Minami. And it will probably do a number on Shinobu as well.
However, this one has Clock on Core, which means my Gigant Shooter deck is much sadder facing this one than the other ones.
Yeah, so I like this a lot more good. Than the Sink.
This card is really just hard. Really solid, if you ask me. I would give it a good rating, to be quite honest.
It's a good card.
Because the entirety of the meta is
playable, but sure.
It's more than playable. This is an excellent card, in my opinion.
It does have, like, the unfortunate consequences that if your opponent does happen to run anything that costs stock, you just get really sad.
I suppose. But you still have Clock on Course, so you can beat down on something that is costless.
I mean, like, how many of this would you even plan to play if they have a cost at level 1, just don't play it?
He's got a good point, especially when you can search, like, Love Life can.
Like, this shouldn't be your main plan.
Yeah, like, if you know what they're playing, like, obviously, if you're playing against, say, LB Twins or Rider.deck, then no, you don't play this card out because it's going to get murdered. But if you
you're
are
playing, like, Madoka.
Yeah, like, Madoka plays... Madoka plays the 1-1 Sire.
Like, one, maybe.
Sure, but you're playing, like, maybe two of this. Maybe.
Yeah, but this is going to stand up to the, like, the Apples
I suppose. Saikas. Yeah, that's a fair point, but... Yeah, I guess.
I mean, usually they're going to drop the 1-1 anyways, because it's the way that they can just ditch Climaxes for very cheap.
You don't Rin need can't to get always back do in, that. Hey?
Well, since Rin can't get back in, that doesn't matter, because it's the last card anyway. I'm going to give this Maki a good, because I think it's a good card.
I'm giving it a good card.
Yep. I think it's pretty good.
Hello, count the stars, Rice Girl.
Okay, this card is fucking shit.
This card is so bad.
God damn it. I'm back to being behind.
So this card is a 2/1/7/5. If you've got 6 or more stock against 1/5 power, so the mad sick combos with the Rin, am I right? And when this attacks, Hello Count the Stars is in the climax zone. Oh wow, yeah, it really is pretty bad. Okay. All your characters gain 2k for the turn.
What did I say?
Pretty bad.
For the turn. Like, it's only for the turn. It's not even till the end of the opponent's turn. What the hell?
So, like, this is... I'm glad to see that Bushiroad waited this long to revert, like, the quality of Hanayo's cards to what they used to be.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I can really say about this.
Please.
Well, at least it's the last card.
You have so many good Hanayo cards now.
Yeah, I know. But it took, like, sets. Like, literal sets to get to good cards.
You know, I think that you're actually being kind of... Like, Maki had worse cards than Hanayo for a long time.
I don't think so. I don't know if this is the right time to get in an argument about this, but set one...
I feel like Hanayo's 1-1 vanilla beat almost all of Maki's level 1 options.
Yeah, but that was the third set of Love Live.
Yes, but my point stands.
Okay, Alf, this card is going to sound really familiar to you. If this card is in the front row, this could not stand during your stand phase. She had a worse version of the Shiki you hate from Melty Blood. Because this is a 3/5, the Shiki's at least a 4k.
Okay, you win. Okay, anyway, this card I can't see being played because it just doesn't do anything.
No, yeah, this card is awful. It doesn't do anything.
I hate stock... like, conditions tied to caustic characters.
Yeah, I agree with
like
that.
It's, like, the worst feel... Oh, my God.
I feel like they had, like, really... Wait, Maki doesn't even have a climax combo with, Hello Count the Stars. So they... I feel like they just made this, like, last minute as filler, I guess. Not even to, like, complete a cycle, just, like...
I do kind of get that feeling.
Look at this picture from the movie we could use on a card.
They should have made this a 1/0 with just the second effect. It still wouldn't have been that good.
She would have gotten...
I still wouldn't play this.
You still wouldn't play it. I don't think they could actually print it at level 1 like that, though.
Because,
let me think. The closest parallel to that effect would be Gigant Shooter on Climax play this gains 2,000 power to end of turn. So
sure.
I don't think you can get away with this at level 0 or level 1. But
yeah.
No, this card's pretty bad.
I'm not high on this card at all. It's bad.
Thank you.
I think that brings us to the end of the full set review.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I guess we can just make a very brief, have a brief break and come back for the overview.
Mm-hmm. We'll be right back.